don't leave to Australia, because no, we can't stay here. No work, no anything, no house. And we can't come to Syria, because there's bomb, fire, everything.
More than 500,000 people, like Ahmad, have fled Syria to take refuge in Lebanon. Finding a place to live is becoming increasingly difficult, especially for the poorest refugees who have often lost everything because of the war. Some have had to sell their possessions to raise money so that they could reach neighboring countries. They often lack money for rent.
So refugees are scattered all over the region, and the other main challenge is definitely shelter. Places are saturated. People are living in unfinished shelters, in garages. Even 2-3 families we have observed in one single room. So living conditions are terrible, are poor. And also people are eventually forced to live in tented settlements.
The MSF teams must deal with the impact of these living conditions on the refugees' health. In winter, more than 50% of patients developed respiratory infections. Some refugees had no choice but to burn plastic or whatever they could find for heating. Crowded conditions in meager, poorly ventilated housing also contribute to the spread of contagious diseases. Lack of proper hygiene has also led to an increasing number of skin infections among refugees. Now, with the arrival of summer, the situation is unlikely to improve.
They have very limited access to water and hygiene. I was in a shelter this week where there's about one toilet for every 60 people. Not good enough. So their risk of communicable disease is very high. Very limited access to food. So yes, we can afford to buy rice, but we can afford nothing else.
The continuing inflow of new refugees across Lebanon has resulted in growing health needs, and MSF has thus expanded its activities in recent months. The organization is providing free medical care in the Bekaa Valley and in the cities of Tripoli and Saida. MSF also provides mental health care to the most vulnerable among the Lebanese population and to people who fled Syria, who in addition to experiencing war-related trauma, must now deal with life as refugees in Lebanon.
Many of them lost also houses, they lost their work, they lost everything. They came in very bad conditions. Plus, they came into places in Lebanon that they are economically disadvantaged. You know, they don't have this fancy living now. They are living in very crowded places, and they are trying as much as they can to integrate into the community. We're afraid to see more major depression among these people, because the frustration is very high and because they are not being able at all to understand the situation, to cope with this new situation that is putting them under too much pressure.